everyone. So today I'll be continuing with my bird series. That's the bird illustration series that I've recently started. And I recently saw this bird on a tree, and so I went on and just drew it on what I saw, and this is what I saw. And I literally went to my sketchbook and did that drawing you saw earlier. And I just thought that it was some local bird, but it's actually a different bird. It comes comes during the monsoon season. It's monsoon, like it's rainy season right now in India, and it's this bird looked really pretty when I saw it. I could have included the clip, like I actually took a video clip of that bird sitting on a tree, but it was not so clear, so I just thought of eliminating that. It was a really beautiful bird. I have tried my best to portray all the colors here, but it was really amazing. The colors, the shades of green that that bird had was really beautiful. And initially I just thought it was some kind of a normal like sparrow like bird. I just thought it might be of that family. I went on and wrote all sorts of name on Google. Like I even took a picture of the drawing I made, and I went on Google image search, and I thought Google would show me similar images, but it did help to some extent. I did came close to the kind of bird I saw, and then you get those images like similar images, and when you open something which looks similar like the way you saw that bird or anything, so there are other images that are related to that image. So I hope you guys can get it. So that's how I found this bird. I went on to Pinterest I was very inquisitive. I really wanted to know what the name of the bird was, because it was really tiny, small, and it was sitting there on the branch of tree. I couldn't go like close to that bird, but I did see it myself. So, and it was not going anywhere, like it was sitting there and it was watching me, and I was watching that bird, and it didn't fly away. Like that bird was not scared that I was about to like click a picture or take out my camera. Usually that happens many times when you go over or near to any bird, it will fly away or and anything of that sort. But I did manage to do that, but it was not so clear, so I just thought I should paint it. That would be really nice. And I was doing a series, like I am doing a series, if any one of you who are new to this channel, I would like you to know that I have been doing this bird series in alphabetical order. So I just thought it would be really nice to do this bird for this letter. The letter is C. I have done a bird with the letter B. So this was the bird that I personally thought would be really nice to draw next to the previous illustration I did on that bird. So I really enjoyed how the colors were, and it really helped me. Like it was like a bit of a challenge, especially when you are painting watercolors, using watercolors to paint those tiny feathers and create those textures, the kind of texture which I'm creating here. I mean, it was, I had to let the base color dry, and then move on with another layer of different shade of green. I have like three shades in my palette. If you want to know what Camlin like watercolor I use, I'll put it in the description box below. And it was really nice and amazing the way I had to think of different techniques to blend all the colors. And sorry for hitting the tripod there. And I really love the way this bird had those bright red colors on the you can see the lower half of the body or the neck area. I really loved the way those bright colors were, and it really that was the color that actually caught my attention when this bird was sitting on the tree. And though I mean, it really had those red feathers on the head, on his head and the neck area, and even his this bird's feet were really red, and it was really bright, the brightest of the bright, I could say. And it was exactly the color of Ruby Woo from the MAC. I'm actually giving a reference of a lipstick because it was so beautiful and so red. I mean, reddest of the red you could ever imagine. The information that's given on in Wikipedia, it's also this bird is also called Coppersmith Barbet. Bird is usually found in the Indian subcontinent and the Southeast Asia, and it's called Coppersmith Barbet because of the fact that this bird makes a coppers like a sound. The way the coppersmith strikes the metal with a hammer, and that is the kind of sound you can describe this bird makes. That's what written on the Wikipedia page. And it mainly eats fruits and insects and termites, I guess, and these are very commonly found anywhere in India, especially where you can find small edible berries and edible things. And there's not much written about this bird, but it's very commonly seen here, and it's abundantly found in the ficus tree, I would say. That's called anjeer in Hindi. And they usually make their nest in the trunk of the tree, and they usually feed on wild figs, bananas and berries, etc. And this bird actually was really like the places where I want to blend all the colors. I'm wetting that area and placing another layer of watercolor and blending it together. So that's the technique that I most often follow whenever I do any kind of blending. So especially in this bird, it needed a lot of blending because there were many sharp areas, like many areas where the colors flew, like it was in a way mixed up that couldn't have been possible if I hadn't blended the colors. So, and here I'm using a very thin brush. I think it's a zero brush or one brush, I don't remember, but it's a round brush, and I'm using it for those small hair this bird has. I've left, yeah, you might be wondering why I've left the eye area blank, because I wanted to use this Sakura micron pen. I often use this for lining my artwork, but since I've done most of the shading using watercolors and outlining, so I won't be outlining much for this sketch. And I've decided not to do that because I've seen many people and many artists outline, like they paint their watercolor pieces in such a way that these line works are not needed, because I think they look very beautiful. I know line work is very important for defining any of your artwork. That's what I say in most of my videos, but however, I feel like I should be practicing different techniques, and maybe that's why I'm using less and less of line work. And I try to avoid, like, I try using minimal line work to my work, and do most of my shading and all those sketching stuff with watercolor as much as I can, or as much as it is possible. So here I am giving those small feather effect with this black sakura micron pen, because watercolor, the black and the watercolor palette was not that dark the way it has to be, or which I thought I should, like, it should be on the board. So I just went on with the sakura micron pen, and I really wanted to give this like branch of a tree a bit of a texture, and so I went on and just did the whole thing. So here's my final sketch. I hope it was nice, enjoyable, and I hope you guys like it. If you do, you can see a close up of my sketch on my Instagram page, and I do many stuff on Instagram, so you guys can follow me there, or you can subscribe here, anyway you want to. So here's my final sketch. I hope you guys like it, and thanks for watching. And I'm really thankful for those who subscribed till now. So yeah, that's it for my third one in the bird series. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye.